What's happening, y'all? This is your girl, Megan. Welcome back to the Hood Astro Queen to all of my returning subscribers. However, if this is your first time on my page today, do both of us a favor. Hit that subscribe button because you know you want to. So today I'm kicking off my free reading, okay? I selected five of them, and I really did it in the order in which I received them. So it was on some first come, first serve type of tip. All right. Therefore, if I did not get around to choosing your submission or your entry, then you can always have your reading prioritized by actually booking a reading, because I always prioritize my paid clients first. I love all y'all the same, but, you know, that option is available. Also, I want to thank everybody. Thank you so much, everyone who submitted an entry, because you guys are really being transparent. I understand people have a lot of things going on in their lives that they would love to have some type of insight on. So yeah, anytime, you know, you're putting yourself in a space of vulnerability to a stranger, because I mean, y'all don't really know me like that, and I don't know y'all like that. I appreciate it, and I love y'all. So I just wanted to get that out the way. However, we're going to start with a young lady who I'm going to call Blueberry, because I like to keep people anonymous unless they specifically request for me not to. And I mean, most people would rather be anonymous. So, okay. Miss Blueberry, her email reads, "I just wanted to say I love your channel and how you give it raw when it pertains to astrology. Thank you. Well, I am a nursing student who is in my 30s. My birthday is May 8th, 1987, and I was born in South Bend, Indiana, I think that's what that is, at 12:45 a.m. Well, I am my mother's only child, and she does nothing but dictate my life. Her birthday is October 31st, 1961. Whoa, she's a Scorpio, so I'm sure that has something to do with it. Okay, and she was born in Cassopolis, Michigan. I think that's what that is. As a child, she was usually very critical and unintentionally lowered my confidence. She is usually a very sweet lady, but she can be very hard to talk to a lot of times, which caused me to fall in a deep depression. She often puts the church, family, or other outsiders before me, and I never truly felt like she has my back. I know she was physically and emotionally abused by her birth mother. I wanted to know how to better understand my mother so that we can build up our relationship." So once again, Blueberry, I want to thank you for your transparency. Thank you for your submission. And yeah, we're going to go ahead and we're going to dig into this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull up your chart and your mother's chart, and then I'll give my synopsis on the situation. So you were born on, as you stated, May 8th, 1987 at 12:45 a.m., which makes you a Taurus Sun, Virgo Moon. And the first thing that jumped out at me was the fact that your Virgo Moon is placed in your eighth house, which, I mean, in and of itself can deal with you having a mother who is very, very, very controlling. She can be rather micromanaging, hard to please, hypercritical with very specific expectations. And, you know, Virgo moons in general, but especially in the eighth house, could, having mothers like that could set the stage for you to be very insecure and critical of self in the future. And that's one of the hallmarks of a Virgo moon, you know, somebody who is very insecure in a lot of ways and very self-doubting and has a lot of self-deprecating tendencies. And a lot of that started in childhood, which, as you referenced yourself, you know, made you very, or her being very critical, unintentionally lowered your self-confidence. So that goes right in line with that eighth house Virgo moon. Growing up, she probably liked things in a very specific and orderly way. Your eighth house Virgo moon could also deal with you having a very, I'm not going to say unstable, but like an uneasy, like, living environment when younger. It can make you someone who is very dissatisfied. Like, you can't really get comfortable, you know, living with her. I mean, it was probably very stressful, as you described. So, I mean, there's that. And with this placement, there is an increased probability that you could even have to be your mother's caretaker later on in life. But we're going to get to that because that's kind of going to tie into some of my own personal opinions. But we're gonna leave that alone for now. Another thing that I noticed was your moon was conjoined to the fixed star Zosma, which could deal with depression. And with it being conjoined to the moon, this could be depression brought on by issues with the mother, right? And then also, you are a Capricorn ascendant. So your ascendant is at the 23rd degree of Capricorn, right there hedging out like towards the later degrees of Capricorn, which also makes Capricorn bleed over into your 12th house as well. So all of this Capricorn energy could absolutely have a lasting effect on your mental health as far as bringing about bouts of depression. Also, being a Capricorn ascendant could give you a respect for authority, you know, that I tend to see with a lot of people who have strong or very prominent Capricorn placements. And it could be so much so that you do it to your own detriment. And we gonna circle back to that as well. Your moon is also at the 11th degree. I meant to mention that number 11 is a very karmic number. It deals with challenges. A lot of people call it like a master number, right? Along with the number 22. So it's very, like I said, karmic in nature, and it can bring about a lot of challenges, right? So with it attached to your moon sign, this is obviously going to be challenges involving the mother. And I mean, the eighth house also deals with karmic situations and situations that are just going to be out of your control. Love, hate relationships. So already, I'm seeing a lot of karmically induced situation or like energy surrounding your mother. Now, looking at your mom's chart, your mother is, let me see, I know she's a Scorpio sun, Leo moon. And Leo moons tend to have a lot of issues with their children or women who have very prominent Leo energy in their chart. That's literally one of the, I guess you could say, the signatures of their Leo energy. They can grow to have lots of issues with their children. Also, I mean, as I stated before, her being a Scorpio definitely reinforces her being controlling. She also has her Mars at the 20th degree of Scorpio, which could just make her straight up overbearing and all consuming. She could also be quite manipulative. That Leo moon, I know you mentioned that she had a birth mother. I don't know if she's adopted or like, because you said her birth mother, but nonetheless, her having a Leo moon could also point towards her seeking approval from her own mother. And it definitely corroborates there being a sense or an element of abuse, as well as her having her moon squaring her Neptune, her being victimized in some type of way, especially by a mother or a mother figure. If she had siblings, the mother could have played favorites, especially if they were male. Okay. And yeah, so, and her being a Leo moon also deals with her being a tyrant at home. So I can only imagine her being just very difficult to live with. She also has a Leo North node, which once again reinforces her having a hard time with children in this lifetime. And I mean, you know, and there's going to be a need for her to learn how to use her heart or operate from the heart space a lot more with her having that Aquarius South node, because it naturally makes her somebody who is a little bit more closed off, detached, like emotionally detached, not really super emotional, not super mushy or anything like that, you know. She can be kind of standoffish. Another manifestation of that Aquarius South node can be bullyish behavior, even by way of the mother, you know. Another very interesting finding in your mother's chart, her Uranus is at the 29th degree of Leo. Now, this is the aneuritic degree, and a lot of astrologers refer to it as the crisis degree. And number one, this reinforces issues with children, family, conflict within the home. Uranus is actually in its detriment in Leo, which deals with your mother being extremely willful and not really being a fair player or team player. This can make her very selfish to the point of, like I said, causing conflict in the home. And it definitely reinforces like this kind of tyrannical behavior. Even if she is like, because I know you said she's a sweet woman, her Mercury is at the 22nd degree of Libra, her Venus is at the 16th degree of Libra, you know, so that kind of does give her this sense of like diplomacy about her, you know what I mean? That could make her like, it can make a lot of these character flaws a lot less noticeable or maybe more passive aggressive in nature. However, her Mercury is squaring her her Jupiter, which is at the 29th degree of Capricorn. Yeah, that kind of cancels out some of that because it can make her just ruthless or and just very, it reinforces her being very rigid and just very unyielding. That Jupiter at the 29th degree of Capricorn can also deal with her being rather militaristic. It reinforces her going to extremes because that's that anaretic degree once again, the crisis degree. Her going through extremes or having extreme beliefs, religious beliefs. That's her dedication to her religion, as you mentioned, or the church. Right, to the point where it's causing problems at home. Her being very dedicated to her convictions, her spiritual religious convictions in a very traditional way. It could also make her extremely dogmatic and all about punishment on some like, oh, if you sin, you go in hell. If you do this, like, you know, she could be very tied to her beliefs and very like, I'm very unwavering in the way that I carry myself and the things that I believe. It could also make her somebody who is kind of secretly insecure and kind of miserable on the low. Her Jupiter is conjoined to her Saturn, which once again produces karmic issues surrounding being a control freak. It can make her a glutton for punishment, and it can also deal with her like politicking within the church. And I'm wondering if a lot of her involvement with these people, because you said she put the church people and other people before you and whatever and whatnot, if a lot of that could have something to do with her keeping up appearances or like a reputation for herself, you know, the way things look, like upholding a certain standard in that regard. Her moon is opposing her Jupiter, which once again reinforces her placing these religious spiritual matters, these kind of like spiritual church politics over her family, or at least over the children. So, you know, there's that, or over you, you said you're her only child, but, and then her sun is squaring her moon, which has me wondering is maybe she has some type of disorder as well. Now, one of the biggest smoking guns also is the fact that her sun is conjoined to her Neptune in the sign of Scorpio. And that deals with her having no boundaries with you. Okay. Scorpio, or not Scorpio, but the sun is our children, right? And that Neptune influence, it's like almost like where she feels like there are no boundaries, no limits. It reinforces that all encompassing energy where everything is like meshed together. There's no separation between your life and hers. That's why she feels so entitled to yield a lot of this control over your life. That's partially the reason. It's partially the reason. Now, I'm going to say this. Going back to your chart, you have Aquarius in the first house as well. Aquarius begins in your first house. Now, Aquarius, one of the signature hallmarks of that Aquarian energy, especially placed in the first house, is rebellion, independence. And this is something I don't feel like you really own. I don't feel like you really own this energy. I feel like you enact more of that Capricorn energy, which, as I stated before, is very consistent with being respectful to tradition and respectful to authority and whatnot. But to further bolster my point, Aquarius is co-ruled by both Uranus and Saturn, and both of those planets are placed in your 11th house of Sagittarius. Now, having Saturn and Sagittarius, first of all, the 11th house deals with our hopes and our dreams and even things that we feel are like out of reach. Sagittarius deals with freedom, you know, feeling like your freedom is out of reach, out of grasp. Saturn placed in Sagittarius deals with somebody who has a need for freedom, but your freedom is going to come at a cost. You know what I mean? Same thing with that Uranus place in the 11th house. This sense of freedom, independence, rebellion, liberation, but it feels very out of reach. I mean, you got to think about it. The 11th house is so far back. It's like, I mean, like literally like right next to the 12th house, which is the spiritual realm, out of this world. So, you know, it can be just so far away from what you think you have access to, but you have more power than you think, which leads me to your lunar nodal placements. Okay. You're a Libra south node. Okay. With your south node falling in your eighth house as well, which makes you somebody who's naturally very compromising. It can make you someone who has a tendency to be over accommodating and passive, especially when it pertains to other people, wanting the path of least conflict. I mean, that's that Libra energy, especially placed in the eighth house. You hate unbalanced situations. A lot of that also has to do with you being a Taurus. You know, it's that Venus influence. You don't want things to be off kilter. Chaotic situations, chaotic environments really fuck with you. So you like, look, okay, fine. My mom wants this. Okay, fine. She feels this way about me. Okay, fine. You said this. Okay, fine. Like you kind of just shrug it off and whatever. You're an Aries North Node, baby. That means in this lifetime, you're going to have to stand up and fight. This is further reinforced with your moon forming a quincunx to both your Jupiter and your North Node. You got to stand up for yourself, Blueberry. You got to. Jupiter in Aries denotes a need for self-actualization. And you have a karma responsibility to fight for what you believe in. Even with your North Node in your second house, that second house is your values. The things that you literally, you believe in, your values, the things that are important to you, the things, your self-esteem, you know what I'm saying? And not letting people walk all over there or make you feel powerless or make, even if it is your mother. Okay, so while you did ask me on like how I could, or ways you guys could mend your relationship, and I'm not saying like, oh, like if your mom, because I get it. She's still your mom. I get it. I get all of that. And I understand what it's like to kind of have a tumultuous relationship with the mother. But based off of your life path, you need to stand up for yourself and do what's right for you. Okay. And yeah, building up a sense of your own self-confidence. And your mom's son is actually in your ninth house, which lets me know that you idealize her very much. Like you care a lot about what she thinks. But putting your foot down is going to be vital, baby, for you to live up to your purpose on a soul level. You see what I'm saying? You need to do this. And also, this is further reinforced, going back to what I said in your mom's chart with her son being conjoined to her Neptune. You have to set boundaries. That's what that looks like. So I'm not saying just, you know, wild out and whatever. And I understand, you know, that might not be in you. And I'm not saying that that's like the right thing to do anyway. I'm just saying like setting boundaries, fighting for yourself, fighting for your own individuality. You know what I'm saying? Like, you have to do it. You have to do it. And also, you know, with your mom, because her having a Leo North Node, I noticed her moon, not her moon, her Scorpio Mars is squaring her North Node, which deals with her needing to release control. And that's what she's going to learn in this time, too, being a Leo North Node. She's going to have to learn how to operate from the heart space, but in a way where, like I said, this square from her Scorpio Mars, she has to resist using control tactics, manipulation tactics over her children and really love you and accept you for who you are. Now, she might try it. She might try it, but that's where you come in, all right? And eventually, you know, I can't promise that like everything is going to be peachy cream, but I do feel like she will grow to, I mean, she only has two options. She can either grow to accept that and adjust accordingly, which if she does, because I mean, we can't control whether she embraces her North Node or not, right? I mean, she probably don't even believe in astrology if she's as religious, and especially with this Jupiter at the 29th degree of Capricorn. We can't control that. You know, but in a perfect world, she would live up to her North Node and really just grow to respect you for who you are and your boundaries, and for, you know, you standing up for yourself, and you guys would exist in harmony forever. But as of now, you can only do your part. You know what I'm saying? And yeah, she may or may not come around. That's just really what it is. But you guys definitely have a karmic relationship. And like I said, with your eighth house moon, it can definitely denote a lifetime of love and hate. And, you know, so it's not to say that your relationship is going to be terrible, but it's not to say that, like, it's just going to go away. I feel like this is going to be a lifelong karmic issue, but you need to do your part and stand up for yourself. And, yeah, that's really the lesson, you know. That's really what it is. So, yeah, this concludes my reading. I hope you found this to be helpful. Feel free to reach out to me if you have any further questions or anything of that nature. And I wish you the best, Blueberry. I really do. So, yeah, make sure you guys practice unconditional self-love so that you can love others. And until the next video, I holla.